So we are in a borrowed vehicle and we are headed to the Langdale Ferry in Sunshine Coast side. And we're gonna go venture across the water back to Vancouver Horseshoe Bay side. And we're gonna go up to the Britannia Mine Museum, which is not far from Squamish. It's just bumpy. So that's where we're going today. It is Thursday, May 24th. Okay, so we are waiting in line at the Langdale Ferry Terminal for the ferry to Horseshoe Bay. It is 10 after 10. The ferry comes at 10:55. So we were told to get here early-ish. There's quite a few cars in front of us. And we're told they start loading at about 20 minutes before the ferry leaves. So that's maybe in about 20-25 minutes from now. So now we're just waiting. And if you're waiting at the ferry, there's like a little food place and some washrooms. I feel like that's about it. I guess you could get out of the car and go walk that way if you wanted for a bit. But that's about it. It's mostly just waiting. We are still waiting. It is 10:25. How are you guys feeling about this?
3 hours late.
It hasn't been 3 hours.
6 hours later.
For the record, it's been about 20 minutes. Check it out.
So this is a compressed air engine. So they put huge air pressure inside of this and then use that, because in this mine there was dangerous gases, and so it made it safer to, they just ran it off of compressed air.
We bought our tickets for the Britannia Mine. We are getting on the 1 o'clock tour. It is now about 12:40. The cafe was closed, so we couldn't have any lunch, but we got some snacks from the gift shop, some muffins, and some water. And now we are just looking around the inside part. There's some stuff, there's a gold panning section, there's some vehicles, there's a few buildings. I think there's a film in one of them, we haven't seen that yet. And then you go up for your tour where they take you into the mine. We are gonna go do that in the next couple minutes. So we made it to the top of the stairs where the tour starts. And Mike thinks they might be filming a movie over there. I will show you. There's someone painting what looks like set pieces over there, and they also, we saw some downstairs as well, and then further down the highway, it looked like there was what looked like a film set. We'll see if we can find out more. We've been given hard hats, and we're told we're just waiting for a couple more people, and then we get to go in this thing. Down to the mine.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bone. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons of number 9 coal, and a straw boss said, well, bless my soul, you load 16 tons and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. And trouble on my middle name. Raised in a canebrake by an old mama line. Ain't no high tone woman make me walk the line. You load 16 tons and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
I will just mention, just you probably noticed by now, but there's a lot of stuff in here set up because they're going to be for a film tomorrow. So in addition to not tripping over rails, be sure you don't trip over a cable or anything either. That's all of the big lighting and stuff is for. So I'd be a little bit more of a theatrical experience than quite what otherwise. Britannia was open from 1904 up until 1974. And back in 1904, this was the kind of drill that they would have been using. Called a piston drill or a wood drill. And it is powered by compressed air. All this stuff up into the cart. Pretty back-breaking work. Yes. Can you guess how much muck in tons a pair of muckers would have to move in 1 8-hour shift? There's a song, I don't know if any of you are familiar, by Tennessee Ernie Ford. You load 16 tons, and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. And that's a song about mucking. The two muckers would have to load 16 to 20 tons of this stuff here in 8 hours, so about an hour, in each hour, each one of them would have to load a ton apiece. All right. A little bit easier than doing it by hand. This guy could move about 20 tons of muck every hour. So it's well outpacing our men with shovels. This would have still been a two-person job, though, because while one person is driving, another person has to go out ahead and scoop everything onto the rails. So you can figure out which job you'd rather have.
Was a mucker like an entry level job?
Yeah, pretty much. That's sort of what you start out doing. Yeah. Mucking was sort of the most basic sort of position. Although, given what we, you know, we later find out about the dust produced in drilling, there was actually a sort of safety advantage there. So I just need to put this back for our next tour. You know, we do like to recycle here at Britannia.
If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't, and a lot of men died. With one fist of iron and the other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You load 16 tons, and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
We did the tour, some updates on the movie. They definitely are filming a movie. We got to see in this big historical mill number 3 building where they were actually shooting the movie, but we weren't allowed to take any pictures or videos in there. Still don't know what movie it is. They're not allowed to tell us, but definitely filming a movie. The tour was actually very cool. There was lots of interesting information they gave you. You got to go into the mine, got to see kind of some of the conditions the miners would have had to deal with through history. It's very cool. Now Mike and the kids are trying to pan for gold.
When you dump it out, look at, that's all the rocks that come out that are just rocks, that are boring rocks. Exactly.
Found some gold, so clearly we're now rich. In this building right here, mill number 3, they are filming something. But we don't know what it is. It's a movie. Back in line for the ferry. This time we are in Horseshoe Bay and we are waiting to get on the ferry back to Langdale. It is 3:45. The ferry leaves at 4:40 and there's quite a few cars here already. No idea if we're gonna get on this ferry or not because we don't really know how to gauge that. Seems like we're not too far back.
I think we're pretty close to the front.
We'll probably get on. I'm knocking on wood while I say that. On the way down from Langdale, we ended up the third last car to be let on. Was it the second last?
Second. Yes.
We were the second last car, so hopefully our luck holds today. We are gonna just sort of wait here. We might walk down. There's a little snack shack up there. We might go down there and check out if there's a snack for us. There's washrooms. Other than that, you kind of just sit here and wait. We also figured out what was filming while we were at the Britannia Mine Museum. A little bit of internet searching found out that it was Descendants 3 is filming. We figured that out based on the fact that when we were in one of the areas they're using as like a film location, there was a sign that said Dr. Facilier's something. And we know he's one of the villains from Disney movies, from The Princess and the Frog. And then we also happened to see a couple of either actors or extras dressed up that looked pretty young and kind of steampunky. And then we also happened to see, because we're obviously
a little too nosy,
super sleuths, we happened to see that the working title for what they were filming was called The Big Sleep. So when I Googled in the car on the way here, found what's filming in around Vancouver, we discovered that the movie Descendants 3 is filming in Vancouver beginning on May 22nd, which was a few days ago, and that the working title while filming was The Big Sleep. So turns out that's what it was. Not sure we're super excited about that because we haven't seen Descendants 1 or 2, but still pretty cool to stumble upon a movie set.
And they were doing filming today, and they're planning on some more filming tomorrow.
Yeah, which would be Friday, May 25th is tomorrow. They're going to film in the mine that we were just in. So that's pretty cool. So we're going to wait here for a bit till we get to get on our ferry and go back to the Sunshine Coast. And this is our view. We are still waiting. It is 4:34. I think the ferry's supposed to leave in 6 minutes, but it doesn't look like any of the vehicles in front of us are moving. So, don't know what that means. Don't know if it just means we're that far back, or if it means that the ferry's gonna be a bit later. Don't know. But if we miss it, next one's supposed to leave in 1 hour. So that's not too bad. It's not like waiting for 2 hours, like on the way here, if you missed it, which we barely made it. So cross your fingers. Not make the 4:40. But the good news is we are third car in line now, and we are right on track for the 5:30 sailing. It's 4:47 right now. And they tell us that as soon as this ferry departs, which it looks like it's doing right now, then the next one will arrive and we'll be able to board quickly, and then we'll be on our way for 5:30. We should arrive back on the Sunshine Coast just after 6. So that's not too bad at all. But yeah, ferries take a long time to come and go. You can see how that would be a real pain if you lived on the island, not on the island rather, you lived on the Sunshine Coast and you wanted to come to Vancouver. It's definitely a bit of a commitment. So there you go.
We are on the ferry now and we're eating. Most of us are done. Astrid's still eating. We had White Spot. Mike and I had a burger. Tristan had a poutine. And Astrid had this pirate pack. Pretty much as soon as we got on, we went right to the food. Oh, there's pirate pack. As soon as we got on, we went to the food, and we were probably not one of the first people in line, but quickly there were lines behind us. It seems like this ferry, because of the timing, a lot of people eating dinner. So we're still sitting in the court-ish area, waiting for Astrid to finish. And then we're going to go back to Gibson's and we're going to go on the beach. So that's what Astrid really wants to do. This is our view. Back in the vehicle. On the ferry, waiting to be allowed off. We're on deck 4. Oh, there goes a bell. That sounds promising. You have to rent.
Still haven't touched it?